Hi guys.
What up?
So it's day three in Koh Lipe. Through the magic of video, we kind of got off the boat and we skipped a few days. Fast forward.
That was my fast forward. Did you like that?
It was quite good.
It was terrible.
No, yeah. Let's ignore that ever happened. So we got to Koh Lipe and we just thought we'd spend the first day chilling, having a look around and kind of catch up on our tans.
Yeah, try even it out after Goa. Because we were covering it since then,
weren't we? Yeah, got really dark arms and then white everywhere else.
But that failed.
It did a bit, didn't it? Someone managed to burn their eyelids. Didn't even know that was a possibility, but yeah.
Now I'm covering the incognito.
No one will ever know, no. Apart from the fact it's now video.
So what did you do?
I have got some invisible shorts on. from the waist down to the knees, I am white, and then everywhere else, I'm pretty red, aren't I?
Fluorescent pink.
Fluorescent pink, yeah.
Got a wonderful photo, but I won't share that with you because
that's
you
redacted.
Deserve that.
It's redacted. No, no one needs to see that, do they?
But today, what are we doing?
We're going snorkeling.
Going snorkeling.
Yeah. So we chose a company called Adang Sea Divers. Main reason being is they're a bit of an eco tour. So they kind of do the usual snorkeling route, but they tend to look after the planet a bit better whilst doing it. So they don't allow their guys to go fishing off the reefs. They don't dump the plastic bottles.
They don't anchor on the reef.
Yeah.
What else don't they do? They don't use a lot of plastic, so everything that you eat from, drink from is reusable. And like little things like that, because you find that a lot of the local companies will like dump things in the ocean, or like they'll go fishing off the end and they don't sort of like look at what they catch. So
yeah, we just thought, you know, the small differences make a big difference. They all add up, don't they?
Yeah.
So we go in snorkeling. We've got 3-4 islands that we're doing.
Yeah, and we're doing like the sunset one as well. So we get a barbecue on the beach, which would be awesome.
Be gorgeous, won't it? It'd be really nice. So yeah, we're looking forward to that.
Yeah. Hope I've never been snorkeling before.
This could be fun.
It could be a disaster. So stay tuned. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Oh, 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 oh,
just stopped off for lunch at Hadzaiko.
We'll go with that.
We'll go with that. It's literally a desert island within the Koh Lipe archipelago, and it is tiny and it is so quiet. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful, yeah. It's beautiful, nice. Oh, you can just hear nature. And more nature.
Have we gone deaf? No, it's just...
Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
So there's just us, two people from our tour and our tour guide, and then three families live on the island, so there's no hotels, no shops, nothing. It's just us guys, the locals, and then our little boat driver just having a break. But we've been on two dives.
Two little snorkeling, two little reefs.
It's just awesome. So the first one was really colourful, there were loads of fish. No idea what they're called, but they're really pretty. And it's really
we've got
awesome.
A little fish guide, and we're having a good few guesses at which ones are which, but yeah, we're probably going to have to go through the footage and see what's what.
But I've never done it before, so it was a really, really good experience for me. You've obviously done snorkeling before, so we'll
do it. It was nice, it was really good. There's loads of fish, like, everywhere you look. You could be a complete novice, heading the complete wrong direction. It probably end up being the right direction.
Yeah, there's just so much to look at. So you have to sort of, like, stay in, like, a buddy system. But honestly, we're, like, pulling each other, like, look at this, and then one ignores the other, and then we lose each other. But it's all
but
good.
But we find plenty of fish, don't we?
So, and then we went to somewhere that was a little bit more bleached, so it wasn't as colourful, but there was nobody there, it was just our group.
Yeah, and no, again, loads and loads of fish, there were schools of fish.
Yeah, it's awesome, schools of fish.
Schools of fish.
Expert over here.
Well, Amber's job safe.
Yeah, and we saw around like little sea cucumbers, and there's a coral like breathing.
It's just one of your worst nightmares, isn't it?
Actually, but... it's not that bad in real life. So I don't like stuff that grows on stuff. Very specific issue. But it's not that bad in real life. I don't like it in pictures still. So you know when we watch back the GoPro footage.
That'll be all my job, won't it?
Not about that. But in the sea, fine.
Yeah, it is absolutely stunning. Like I say, we've seen loads of, there was a sea snake that we missed.
Oh, I missed that. And then that little weird seahorsey snake.
It had the face of a seahorse. Had the face of a seahorse. And the body was similar but more elongated and kind of moved a bit more like
a
snake.
It was like a snake that was a coral.
Yeah, it was pretty cool though.
It was great.
Very different opinions on the seahorsey thing, the seahorse.
So we've just had lunch, and now we're going on another dive, and then we're going to go watch the sunset. Can we look in?
Beautiful.
Let's go. So we got back in the dark, so after our snorkeling trip and watching the sunset, which was on fire,
it was
beautiful. Yeah.
We'd love to show you a time lapse, but one of us not going to mention any names or point. Not gonna name any fingers or point at any names.
I might have taken 241 consecutive photos of the sunset rather than a time lapse of it.
Do you reckon we'll be able to find one good one? One good photo out of those 241?
Maybe. But I mean, it is the first time you've done it. So
we'll go with that. Yeah, we'll go with it.
All forgivable. So we're walking back from dinner now. And tomorrow, we're off on a new adventure. So tomorrow we're going to
Koh Lanta.
So we have gone for the cheaper option and we're going overland. So we're getting a
from an island, yeah? Overland from an island.
Yes.
Somehow that's an option.
It's like, you know, the magic road in Mario Kart.
Is it like the rainbow road?
That's it.
Is it,
yeah,
like the rainbow
it's
road?
Like that. No, we're getting a ferry from Koh Lipe back to dry land. Long ass minibus somewhere to another pier and then a boat, we hope, to Koh Lanta.
Well, yeah, as long as we're not swimming, that might be helpful.
Yeah, so we're looking at a 9 a.m. start. We should get there for 4 p.m.
Yeah.
So we might be there next week. Don't know.
4 p.m. They didn't say what day, did they? 4 p.m. the day after tomorrow.
But we saved £30.
Yeah, after a conversation last night. We thought, you know, £30. We're trying to aim for about £40 a day.
About £40 a day, yeah.
Budget. And the last few days, we've kind of smashed that out of the water.
Yeah.
Quite nearly double. So, we thought we'd save £30 doing the land option. It's going to be a bit of a pain in the arse, but it's not the longest journey we've done, is it?
No,
by
if
a
we
long
think
shot.
Back to India, it's nothing.
Yeah, absolutely nothing. So, saves us £30. We're gonna head back to the room now, pack all our shizzle, and kind of plan Koh Lanta, really, aren't
we? Eat all those biscuits. Right, I think it's time for good night and goodbye.
Night.
Night. I'm not afraid of the dark.